Hello everybody, hello, hello, hi, hi, hello, welcome back. My name is Katie and I got new bookshelves. No mug today, just water, trying to drink some more water. I guess I'll show you another sticker. I have this one, which is the White Lotus tile from Avatar The Last Airbender, which I love. So about a month ago now, this happened when I was trying to rearrange my bookshelves and I was gonna make a video, so I got it on camera. Yeah, so my bookshelves that I got at Walmart decided they didn't want to be bookshelves anymore. And I have been wanting new bookshelves for a while, but I'm a renter, so I was waiting to kind of make the investment until I found a place of my own. But I think I'm going to be in this space for a while, and I feel like making the investment is going to cut down on me buying new Walmart bookshelves like every couple of years when they start to break. So hopefully these ones will last a really long time. These are the iconic IKEA Billy bookshelves. I got three of them. I did end up filming pretty much the entire process except for taking apart the old shelves and physically building the new shelves. So I have the process filmed for you guys. I will show that to you, and then I think I'm gonna do a bookshelf tour after so you can see things up close and personal. Also, there's a point in here where I was setting up my camera to film after dinner and we had the windows open because it was super nice, but my boyfriend decided to like climb up the side of the house and talk to me through the window when I thought he was in the living room, and I got that on camera, so I might slow that down for you guys so you can revel in my like throaty scream. so this is an overview of my shelves. I can't pull my tripod back far enough because there's a bed in the way for you to see them all at once. That's my cat meowing in the background. But this is kind of what I got going on. So on that very top shelf there, I have a kind of mismatched set of Harry Potter books, some Taylor Swift stuff up here, my Robin Hood collection, and then some childhood books and travel books over there. Just some little trinkety stuff. I didn't want to put too many books on the top. On this first shelf up here, I've got my classics and my poetry collection. So you can see some of my classics over here, and then my Shakespeare collection and poetry on the other side. I really like the way this shelf looks. I think they all work together. The shelf has some of my nonfiction. It's not all of it. I have a lot of natural resources and environmental nonfiction that I have on other bookshelves because that more has to do with my work. There's no real rhyme or reason to this organization. I just thought it looked pretty. Then over here we have some adult fiction on this side, and then I have three dark academia books kind of smushed together in the middle there, followed by some adult romance-ish on this side. Moving down, we have my main adult fantasy shelf, and so I've got things like Crescent City on one side. I have the entire Every Heart a Doorway series behind this one. Actually, I kind of like this cover maybe a little bit better. That one's kind of cool. Maybe we'll put that one up. I might rotate those because I do like all of those Hidden Door covers. And then I got the first three books in the Bone Season, the Nevernight Trilogy, Black Sun on the other side. This is my main adult fantasy shelf. Then over here we have my Town of French books. I think they just look so lovely together, and she's one of my favorite authors, so I decided to give her a cube. And then over here, I've got the adult mystery and the young adult mystery slash horror-ish kind of split into these shelves because I don't have enough to really fill an entire shelf of just mysteries. This is one of the first young adult fantasy shelves that I have going on. I have, and there's some middle grade too, the Aragon series, the Inkheart series, Kiss of Deception slash Mary E. Pearson's up there. A couple first books in series that I've read but haven't continued on with yet. Then we have my Grisha shelf. These books just look so lovely together, and I love Leigh Bardugo. Even though I put Ninth House up there, I wanted to keep all the Grisha books together. Then here is my second young adult fantasy shelf. These, I was kind of doing like my favorites on this side versus the other side, but I don't keep books that I don't like, so I love all of these books. But if I had to choose, like, these are some of my favorite young adult fantasy, even though Court of Thorns and Roses, man, that's an adult series, let's be honest. Moving down my first young adult contemporary shelf, these are young adult contemporary favorites, but also they're all hardback because I thought that looked really nice. Then this middle shelf I reserved for Mistborn. Obviously, as I read more Brandon Sanderson, this shelf will probably fill up, but I kind of love it in its simplicity right now. I think it looks so cute. And over here we have more young adult fantasy, but this is like historical fantasy on this side, and then on this side it's just straight up historical fiction on this other side. I don't know if you there, right there. So I don't know, I don't have a lot of historical fiction, but those books weren't really fitting anywhere else, so I kind of thought this was fun to do, to put historical fantasy, historical fiction. I don't know. So this is my sci-fi dystopian shelf. So got Hunger Games, Scythe, Red Rising, all of that good stuff on there. And at the very bottom is my like vampire, Twilight and Vampire Academies down there. And in that basket is just like my filming stuff because I had a lot of extra space. All right, so in the middle here is Game of Thrones, obviously, on top, one of my favorite series of all time. And then Throne of Glass, that series just looks so nice together that I decided to give it its own cube.
And then finally, we have my second young adult contemporary shelf. So Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants is over here. Then some more like hard-hitting contemporaries. And then on the bottom, I've got Cassandra Clare, so Mortal Instruments.
So that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want a full like title by title bookshelf tour, let me know down in the comments below, because those are a lot of work to film. So if you want it, I'll do it. But if not, I'm not gonna bother. They are really fun to watch. It's something soothing about people going through their bookshelves. I don't know. I love them. But yes, that is it. Leave a like if you liked this video. Subscribe if you want to. You don't have to, but I will leave you there. Bye!